الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر لا إله
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد ابن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحابة أجمعين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته أوصي نفسي وإياكم بتقوى الله My brothers and sisters in Islam, it is narrated from Abi Darda that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّكُمْ تُدْعَوْنَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ بِأَسْمَائِكُمْ وَأَسْمَاءِ آبَائِكُمْ فَأَحْسِنُوا أَسْمَاءَكُمْ That on the day of judgment, you shall be called by your names and by your father's names. Therefore, give yourselves good names. In another hadith narrated by Jabir bin Abdullah, radiallahu anhuma, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is reported to have said, Tasammaw bi asma'il anbiya'i. Name yourselves with the names of the prophets. Name yourselves, choose for yourselves, choose for your children the names of the prophets. وَحَبُّ الْأَسْمَاءِ إِلَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ And the names that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves most are the names of Abdullah and Abdul Rahman. And the hadith goes on. So the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has instructed us that when we choose names for our children, we should give them good names. And among the names that he recommends are the names of the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. While many of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have had thousands and millions of children named after them, there is one prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala among the 25 prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who Allah has named in the Quran that few parents are brave enough to name their children after this beloved prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we all know that as Muslims, one of the pillars of our faith is to believe in all the prophets and messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But among the 25 prophets who have mentioned by Allah in the Quran, there is one. There is one of them that few among parents are brave enough to name their children after this prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not because of anything of his doing, and not because of anything of his undoing, but because of the doing of his people. That parents, a number of them are uncomfortable to call their children by the name of this Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is none other than Nabi Lut alayhi salam. I checked my contacts. I have over 3,200 contacts on my phone, and I have not a single of my contacts with the name of Lut. But I have many with Adam. I have many with Nuh. I have many with Sulaiman. I have many with Isa. And you name them, name them, name them. But I ask any one of you sitting here today, how many of you have heard a person called by the name of Nabi Lut alayhi salam? I ask. Anyone tell me, has anyone here come across a person who has been named after Nabi Lut alayhi salam? Why? And this is a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That when we mention his name, what do we say? Alayhi salam. May peace be upon him. Why? Because of the shameful act. Because of the heinous act. Because of the immoral acts that his people engaged in. That is why people fear. Because subhanallah, whenever his name is mentioned, it is quickly associated with the amal of Qawm Lut. My brothers and sisters, Muslims today, and people of the world are finding themselves under siege. People of the world today are under siege, being bombarded with messages about homosexuality, being bombarded with messages about LGBTQ+. And we are being forced to accept this undesired behavior, a behavior that was never known on earth before the people of Qawm Lut. Today, when we speak against homosexuality, as I am going to speak today, because that is the position of Islam, and it will never change. The position of Muslims and Islam against homosexuality will never change ila yawm al-qiyamah. Come what happens. Whatever forces and whatever might are going to be behind propelling and pushing this undesired behavior down the throats of people of the world, the Islamic position will never change. When we speak against homosexuality, we are portrayed as attacking people's identities. Because historically, homosexuality throughout the history of man was associated with an act, not identity. Throughout history, homosexuality was simply associated with actions and not the identity of people. However, today, entire identities and institutions are built around this sexual orientation. LGBTQ. LGBTQ+. What is it? What does it stand for? LGBTQ+ is an acronym. Acronym of the identity of persons with certain behaviors. L stands for lesbians, which refer to a group of women who are attracted either sexually or romantically to other women. The G is for gays, which refers to men who are attracted sexually or romantically to other men. And then we have the T. Or before that, we have the B, which stands for bisexual, which refers to a person who is attracted sexually and or romantically to both men and women. Then we hear about transgender, the T. Now here, it refers to a person whose gender identity is against his or her physical features. A person whose physical features clearly show that he's a man, but he feels he's a woman and behaves like a woman. Or a woman whose physical features clearly show that she's a woman, but she identifies herself as a man. Q. Start wondering, what is this Q for? It's for queer. Queer. Or sometimes, or a question. People who do not know, who claim to not know their identity, whether they are men or women, subhanAllah. And now there is a plus. That plus is there for expansion. Anything else that will come can be added. It's there for expansion. And yesterday, when I was Googling, just to understand clearly what this acronym of LGBTQ plus stands for, I saw another addition. LGBTQAI plus. So now there is AI plus. So the plus is there for expansion, which means that the agenda is big. To provide expansion, to include more and more people with such kind of undesired behavior. What is the Islamic position against homosexuality? And when you look at all these, LGBTQ, all of them fall under homosexuality. All of them. They fall under homosexuality. We remind ourselves and remind the world that Islam categorically prohibits homosexuality. Its teachings, the teaching of Islam on gender relations and sexual norms are fundamental. They are fundamental and they are not separable. You cannot separate them from the belief in Allah. And you cannot separate them from the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is foundational and fundamental. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, defined mankind as male and female. This is the definition of the creator azza wa jal. When he said in the Quran, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, Ya ayuhan nas, inna khalaqnakum min zakarin. Inna khalaqnakum min zakarin wa unsa. O mankind, this verse was not addressed to the believers. This verse was addressed to the whole of mankind. It was addressed to the whole of humanity. Allah says, O mankind, indeed, we have created you from a male and female. This is how Allah Azza wa Jalla has defined mankind. Male and female. There are no lesbians, there are no gays, there are no transgenders, there are no bisexuals. Male and female. And this verse clearly states that mankind can only be formed. Mankind can only be formed by the pair. Two opposite genders, male and female, no same gender can give birth to a child. No two men can give birth to a child. And no two female can give birth to a child. No wonder in the WhatsApp, there was a lot that was said about the statements of the late President Mugabe. And I think you saw it in the WhatsApp. It's alleged that he said, lock them in jail until one of them gives birth. I think you've seen this in the WhatsApp. Where Mugabe said, if a male wants to have a marriage with a man, put them in jail and free them only when one of them has given birth. It will never happen. Now, Islam affirms that men and women spiritually are equal in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's a clear position of Islam. That men and women spiritually are equal before the creator of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, each of them has different characteristics. Physically, biologically, even emotionally. They are different. And because of this, the two have different roles. And that's why we've always advocated for this statement. That Islam accepts that men and women are equal but not identical. Islam accepts that men and women are equal but not identical. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given each one of them duties, obligation, and rights depending on their nature. So if they are not identical, they cannot have identical rights. If they are not identical, they cannot have identical duties. If they are not identical, they cannot have identical obligations or identical roles. In Islam, sexual relations are only permitted within the boundaries of marriage. In Islam, sexual relations are only permitted in the boundaries of marriage. And marriage can only occur between a man and a woman, even under the Constitution of Kenya. In the Quran, Allah explicitly, not implicitly, explicitly, clearly condemns sexual relations with the same gender. And he says, وَالَّذَانِ يَأْتِيَانِهَا مِنْكُمْ فَآذُوهُمَا. If two men commit a lewd act of homosexuality, punish them both. This is the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If two men engage in homosexuality or sexual intercourse, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, punish them both. And subhanallah. The Sahaba, the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said that we never knew that a man could have sexual intercourse with another man. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had not revealed this verse, we would never have known. Meaning, among the Quraysh, this was an act that was never known. Of a woman having a sexual relationship with another woman, or a man having sexual relationship with another man. But look at the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, فَإِن تَابَ. Here he says, punish them. But he says, فَإِن تَابَ وَأَصْلَحَ فَأَعْرِضُوا عَنْهُمَا. If they repent, subhanallah, وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. If they repent and mend their ways, then leave them alone. So I am telling you, my brothers, in the event that we have people in our community or society who for some reason engage in this undesirable behavior, but they were guided and they repented, please do not continue with the stigma. Leave them alone. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna Allah kana tawwabar rahima. Indeed, God is always ready to accept repentance. He is full of mercy. The people of Lut are the first people on earth to have practiced homosexuality. The first people on earth to have practiced homosexuality are the people of Lut. Allah says in the Holy Quran, وَلُوتًا إِذْ قَالَ لِقَوْمِهِ أَتَأْتُونَ الْفَاحِشَةَ مَا سَبَقَكُمْ بِهَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ مِنَ الْعَالَمِينَ. He's asking them, do you commit such immorality that no man has ever done before? عَالَمِينَ, the world. So this was an act not known among men. This was an act not even known among the jinn. But the people of Lut started this. And why am I saying this? Because the main strategy of the advocates of LGBTQ is to convince the world that this behavior is normal. That's their agenda. That this behavior is normal, and that people who are attracted to the same gender are born that way. That they are born that way. That this behavior is biological. This behavior is genetic. La hasha. Far from the truth. Because if it was biological, if it was genetic, then this act would have been committed by those before Qawm Lut. The fact that they are the ones who started it is evidence enough. And this is the creator. Lot is telling them, إِنَّكُمْ لَتَأْتُونَ الرِّجَالَ شَهَوَةً مِّن دُونِ النِّسَاءِ. You lust after men. You lust after men. You desire men instead of women. بَلْ أَنْتُمْ قَوْمٌ مُسْرِفُونَ. You are certainly transgressors. So let us not be tricked to believe that this is biological origin. It is not. It is an acquired behavior. They acquired it, the people of Lut, and those who practice LGBTQ today also are acquiring it. Homosexuality goes against the natural disposition of man, the fitrah. It goes against it because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the fitrah He has put in us is that a man shall be attracted to a woman and a woman shall be attracted to a man. Brothers and sisters, until the 1970s, homosexuality was frowned upon and was considered unnatural. It was considered an unnatural act virtually by all societies, by all cultures, by all traditions. However, today, with a powerful, well-funded lobby group, these actions started getting acceptance and normalized in the West. At present, LGBTQ, subhanal advocacy, is part of a global agenda. It's a global agenda by Western states and the United Nations. They are the ones who are advocating and funding and pushing this agenda. Part of the political agenda of this movement is the destruction and abolition of the family. And we know family is the foundation of civilized societies. In the West, the agenda has succeeded. And the focus now is on Africa and other third world states. The impact of homosexuality can clearly be seen in the West, where the family unit is broken, where men and women remain unmarried, and there is also a population decline. They have exerted their influence in different sectors. First, education. In education. Then also in business, in media. All opportunities are being used by the LGBTQ movement to advance their agenda. One of their strategies is to remove laws against homosexuality. And I don't know whether you are aware that as we speak now, there is a case in the Court of Appeal in Kenya. Where the LGBTQ movement wants to have the law prohibiting homosexuality repealed. Because homosexuality, under the penal code of Kenya, is a criminal act. It's criminal. And alhamdulillah, this mosque, Jamia Mosque, and Ummah Foundation are among the parties in court fighting against this evil. More troubling, my dear brothers and sisters, is the silent and secret programs of this group to impose literature and curricula on our children in schools to make them accept homosexuality as normal behavior. In February this year, the Tanzanian government banned a popular children's book series, Diary of a Wimpy Kid. I think you've seen it also here. Diary of a Wimpy Kid. The Tanzanian government banned that book. Why? Because it was clear that the content of that book was promoting homosexuality among children. So parents, compete for your space as parents, because there are others who are competing for that space to misguide our children. It is time we took interest in what our children are being taught in schools and what books they are being asked to read. And more important, you need to be careful where you have subjects like sexual reproductivity. Those are the kind of terminologies that are actually used in these schools, or the family. I saw a book where the family unit is described as a woman and a man, one kind of family, another kind of family, man and man, that's another kind of family, third is women and women. So children are being taught that these are families in our schools. Definitely, there is an increasing push by the Western countries, as well as organizations, to promote LGBTQ in African countries like Kenya. And this was clear during the visit of the former president of USA, Barack Obama, in 2015, when he openly came to Kenya and pushed the case for homosexuality rights. But former President Uhuru Kenyatta told him on his face that we will not sacrifice our inherent religious and traditional value. It was open. And we call upon His Excellency, our President, William Samoei Ruto. Just like the presidents of our neighboring countries in Uganda and Tanzania, we laud Yoweri Museveni for taking a stand against homosexuality. We laud President Samia Suluhu for taking a stand against homosexuality. So we also urge our President, William Samoei Ruto, to show his will and commitment to fight this sinister move that is aimed at legalizing homosexuality and destroying the fabric of the family unit in Kenya. As I said, our constitution clearly states that marriage is between a man and a woman. And I've also said that as per our penal code, homosexuality is a crime punishable by a jail sentence of up to 14 years. In Kenya, it is punishable by a jail sentence of up to 14 years. It is strange and defeats logic and understanding that three judges of the Supreme Court chose to ignore these legal provisions. And they ruled that groups promoting homosexual relationships have a right of association. Groups that are promoting homosexual behavior have a right of association, and that they be allowed to register themselves as non-governmental organizations. Like other Kenyans, Muslims, as Muslims, we totally oppose this ruling. And we say that these three judges did a great disservice to the Constitution and the people of Kenya, and they are not fit to hold such an honorable, weighty, and mighty position of responsibility in this country. They should actually resign, because they have betrayed the Constitution of Kenya, and they have betrayed the trust that Kenya has placed in that court, the Supreme Court. On the other hand, we commend and laud the two justices who disagreed and dissented against that ruling, Justice Muhammad Ibrahim and Justice William Ouko. These are the true heroes and the patriots of this nation, because they took a stand. We ask these three judges, in the spirit of the words of the two justices, Muhammad Ibrahim and William Ouko, will you then allow thieves, robbers, rapists, and terrorists to have a right of association? Will you allow robbers, rapists, thieves, and terrorists who are considered criminals under our penal code to also have a right of being registered as a non-governmental organization? Wallahi, shame on you. As Muslims, we support the efforts of Homa Bay MP, Homa Bay Town MP Peter Kaluma, and call upon legislators, both in the National Assembly and also the Senate, to come out in full support of the Family Protection Bill of 2023. This bill aims at safeguarding our morals, safeguarding and protecting our families, culture, religious values that we as Kenyans hold in very high regard. This is a very disturbing topic, and I don't have much time, and my sheikh is there, but I want to say this. The people of Lut, because of their action, were punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a manner that he had never punished any people before them because of their acts. Just like their act was unprecedented in history, that their destruction and punishment was also unprecedented in history. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in destroying these people, sent the angel Jibreel alayhi salam. If you read the verse on their destruction, Allah talks about their land and also talks about sending down stones made of clay, marked. Those stones were marked by their names, so that each stone was particular to somebody. And the ulama tell us that Jibreel, with the tip of his wing, picked that land, raised it until their voices and the voices of their animals could be heard in heaven, and turned upside down and slammed them back to the ground. No people have ever been destroyed with such kind of punishment. They were buried alive by Jibreel alayhi salam. And those who were away, not all of them were there, those who were away, maybe they had traveled, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent those clay, and they were destroyed wherever they were, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to wipe this qawm and this behavior off the earth. Again, Allah did not punish only those who were doing this act, but also those who accepted it, those who supported it, those who encouraged it. The wife of Lut, Ra'ata Lut, was never among them. She never engaged in that act. But why was she destroyed? The wife of a prophet, why was she destroyed? Because she accepted it. Because she supported it. Because she encouraged it. Because she also facilitated it. Allah destroyed them. And we warn those that are in power and those that Allah has given them capacity and resources, that Allah will punish not only those who engage, but you, just like the wife of Lut. And we warn even the Supreme Court judge, the three of them who decided to rule in favor of this group. Lastly, my brothers, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam feared for this ummah. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam feared for this ummah. And he said, "Inna akhwafa ma akhafu ala ummati amalu qawm Lut." There is nothing I fear more for my people than the deed of the people of Qawm Lut. And he said that this is an alama, it's a sign of Qiyamah. It's a sign of Qiyamah. Lastly, I conclude with this. I appeal to my brothers and sisters in Islam who for some reason have found themselves in this act. Sincerely repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And mend your ways. And never lose hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never lose hope. Because Allah says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَتُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Oh, my servants who have transgressed against themselves by sinning, do not lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah forgives all sins. إِنَّهُ وَغَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Surely, He is most forgiving and most merciful. And anyone who is bent on continuing to practice sin or encourage it or support it, then fear the torment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And let what happened to the people of Lut be a serious reminder of the consequences of this act, both here on earth and in the hereafter. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم والبر الكريم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We've been listening to Professor Abdul Latif Isaji. He's our deputy chairman of Jamia Mosque, Nairobi. Our khatib is Sheikh Ahmed Noor Muhammad Haji. Sheikh was unwell for a few days, but he's back. We welcome you, Sheikh. Please welcome. He's going to be our khatib and our imam for today. Just one announcement. Our collection goes to a mosque, a very small mosque in Thika town called Jami Muslim Mosque. The mosque needs a lot of repairs, a lot of assistance. They have a pay bill which we have already put on the table, on the boxes, but I can just share with you the number very quickly. Their pay bill number is 552800 and the account number is 010-820-418-4001. It's a long number, but the number is already pasted in all the collection boxes. Jazakumullah khair wa assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر لا إله إلا
الحمد لله رب العالمين على نعمة الإسلام والإيمان والحمد لله أن جعلنا من أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم خير أمة أخرجت للناس، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. أما بعد، أيها المسلمون، لقد خلق الله عز وجل الإنسان وركب فيه شهوة جنسية ولم يجعل لها إلا طريقًا واحدًا مشروعًا للإشباع بها، وهو زواج الرجل بامرأة يتعفف بها وتتعفف به ويسكن إليها وتسكن إليه. قال سبحانه وتعالى: ومن آياته أن خلق لكم من أنفسكم أزواجا لتسكنوا إليها وجعل بينكم مودة ورحمة إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يتفكرون. ومن خلال هذه الرابطة الظاهرة والميثاق الغليظ بين الزوجين يحصل التكاثر اللازم لبقاء النوع البشري. قال سبحانه وتعالى: والله جعل لكم من أنفسكم أزواجا وجعل لكم من أزواجكم بنين وحفدة ورزقكم من الطيبات أفبالباطل يؤمنون وبنعمة الله يكفرون. وهي سنة عامة في جميع البشر بل وحتى الحيوانات أن يكون من كل نوع زوجين ذكرا وأنثى. قال سبحانه: ومن كل شيء جعلنا زوجين ومن كل شيء خلقنا زوجين لعلكم تذكرون. فتلك سنة الله تبارك وتعالى في خلقه، وتلك فطرته التي فطر أهل الأرض عليها. لكن مع الأسف الشديد، أناسا من بني آدم عكسوا ونبذوا فيما خلق الله تبارك وتعالى لهم من الأزواج والزوجات، وانطلق يشتهي الرجل الرجل ويتمنى ممارسة اللواط معه، والمرأة تشتهي المرأة وتتمنى ممارسة الجنسية الشذوذ معها، يسمونها باسم الحرية الكاملة، وبئس الحرية، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. أيها الأحبة في الله، لقد مرت على البشرية قرون طوال وما فكرت في فعل ذلك أبدا، مع كثرة ما اقترفت من الذنوب والموبقات والآثام، ولا خطر لها على بال، حتى جاء قوم لوط، نبي الله لوط عليه الصلاة والسلام، وصنوا على هذه الفعلة الرذيلة القبيحة الشنيعة. قال سبحانه: ولوطا إذ قال لقومه أتأتون الفاحشة ما سبقكم بها من أحد من العالمين إنكم لتأتون الرجال شهوة من دون النساء بل أنتم قوم مسرفون. ولطالما ناصحهم لوط عليه السلام ليرجعوا عن غيهم فيما فعلوا. قال سبحانه: أتأتون الذكران من العالمين وتذرون ما خلق لكم ربكم من أزواجكم بل أنتم قوم عادون. فما كان جوابهم إلا أن قالوا: لئن لم تنتهي يا لوط لتكونن من المخرجين. ولقد تمادوا في غيهم وطغيانهم حتى أرادوا الملائكة الذين جاءوهم بالعذاب، ولقد راودوه عن ضيفه فطمسنا أعينهم فذوقوا عذابي ونذر. وما زالوا مستمرين في طغيانهم وسترتهم حتى نزل عليهم أشد عذاب عرفته البشرية. قال سبحانه: فلما جاء أمرنا جعلنا عاليها سافلها وأمطرنا عليهم حجارة من سجيل ممدود مسومة عند ربك. أيها المؤمنون، إن الإسلام حرم تحريما قطعيا ما يصنعه الرجل مع الرجل والمرأة مع المرأة من الشذوذ الجنسي بكل صوره وأشكاله وأنواعه، وتوعد عليه بأشد العقوبات. فهذا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يبشر فاعليه بأمراض فتاكة تستعصي على العلاج قائلا يا معشر المهاجرين خمس إذا ابتليتم بهن وأعوذ بالله أن تدركوهن لم تظهر الفاحشة في قوم قط حتى يعلنوا بها إلا فشى فيهم الطوعان والأوجاع التي لم تكن مضت في أسلافهم الذين مضوا رواه ابن ماجه. وجزاء هذه الفعلة الرذيلة القبيحة هي القتل بيد ولي الأمر إن كان يوجد ولي أمر المسلمين. وعن ابن عباس رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم قال من وجدتموه يعمل عمل قوم لوط فاقتلوا الفاعل والمفعول به. من وجدتموه يعمل عمل قوم لوط فاقتلوا الفاعل والمفعول به رواه الترمذي. فاتقوا الله عباد الله، اتقوا الله أيها المسلمون، واستيقظوا وتنبهوا وأفيقوا من غفلتكم. وليدافع كل منا حسب قدرته وطاقته الشرف والقيم ومبادئ الإسلام، وخاصة من له صوت في البرلمان الكيني أو له جاه في سلطة القرار، وحتى الدعاء الذين لا يستطيعون شيئا حتى الدعاء في جوف الليل على المروجين والداعمين وهي أضعف الإيمان. وتيقنوا عباد الله، تيقنوا علم اليقين أن هذه شذوذ القدر الفضاء، أن هذه شذوذ القدر الفحشاء هي خراب ودمار وقضاء على النوع البشري جمعاء، ونشر للأمراض الفتاكة، وجلب لغضب الله تبارك وتعالى ومقضه وعقابه وعذابه. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ومن يهن الله فما له من مكرم إن الله يفعل ما يشاء. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم، ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد أيها المسلمون، أوصيكم نفسي بتقوى الله تبارك وتعالى، فاتقوا الله وأطيعوه أيها المؤمنون. واعلموا إننا نعيش في زمن قد كثر فيه الفتن ودواعي الإباحية والزنا واللواط وجميع أنواع الفواحش والقذر، وتضاعف دعاتها وتنوعت قنواتها ومواقعها ووسائلها وأسبابها حتى وصلوا كأنهم بهائم وليسوا من بل البشر. وإن اللواطية كما ثبتت تسميتها بذلك عن الصحابة هي إتيان النساء وجماعهن من أدبارهن، وذلك من أعظم المحرمات وأقدرها على دين الزوج والزوجة، حيث ثبت أن النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم قال من أتى امرأة في دبرها فقد كفر. وثبت عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أيضا أنه قال من أتى أدبار الرجال والنساء فقد كفر. فاتقوا الله أيها المسلمون، اتقوا الله عباد الله، اتقوا الله في تربية أبنائكم وأولادكم وبناتكم، واحرصوا على إصلاحهم، وادفعوا عنهم أسباب الفساد، وجنبوهم قدر استطاعتكم مخالطة هؤلاء، مخالطة من لا تثقون به، مخالطة من لا تثقون بدينهم وخلقهم وأمانتهم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد، واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. صلوا وسلموا على رسول الله، فقد أمركم الله بذلك في كتابه العزيز حيث قال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك اللهم على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. ورضى اللهم عن خلفاء الأربع أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن بقية أصحاب رسول الله أجمعين وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، وأذل الشرك والمشركين، وانصر عبادك المؤمنين، ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من منكرات الأخلاق والأعمال والأهواء. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم إنا نسألك المعافاة في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
استووا استقيموا واعتدلوا تقاربوا أكملوا الصف الأول فالأول لا تختلفوا. الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول ولا تبطلوا أعمالكم إن الذين كفروا وصدوا عن سبيل الله ثم ماتوا وهم كفار فلن يغفر الله لهم. فلا تهنوا وتدعوا إلى السلم وأنتم الأعلون والله معكم ولن يتركم أعمالكم. إنما الحياة الدنيا لعب ولهو وإن تؤمنوا وتتقوا يؤتكم أجوركم ولا يسألكم أموالكم. إن يسألكموها فيحفكم تبخلوا ويخرج أضغانكم. ها أنتم هؤلاء تدعون لتنفقوا في سبيل الله فمنكم من يبخل ومن يبخل فإنما يبخل عن نفسه والله الغني وأنتم الفقراء. وإن تتولوا يستبدل قوما غيركم ثم لا يكونوا أمثالكم. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين والسماء بنيناها بأيد وإنا لموسعون والأرض فرشناها فنعم الماهدون ومن كل شيء خلقنا زوجين لعلكم تذكرون ففروا إلى الله إني لكم منه نذير مبين ولا تجعلوا مع الله إلها آخر إني لكم منه نذير مبين كذلك ما أتى الذين من قبلهم من رسول إلا قالوا ساحر أو مجنون أتواصوا به بل هم قوم طاغون فتول عنهم فما أنت بملوم وذكر فإن الذكرى تنفع المؤمنين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
أستغفر الله أستغفر الله أستغفر الله اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام تباركت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير اللهم لا مانع لما أعطيت ولا معطي لما منعت ولا ينفع ذا الجد منك الجد لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه له النعمة وله الفضل وله الثناء الحسن لا إله إلا الله مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون سبحان الله الحمد لله الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يئوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير
Horizon TV, the beacon for the nation. Horizon